Hi, my name is Sreya, and I'm a postbaccalaureate research fellow at the National Institutes of Health. If you've heard of the toxin called anthrax, it's probably from news stories or TV shows about its use as a dangerous bioweapon. However, anthrax can also be used to save lives. My research at NIH specifically aims to turn it into a tool for fighting cancer. Anthrax is made by bacteria found in soil and has two main parts, called the protective antigen and the lethal factor. The protective antigen acts like a pickup truck that delivers the lethal factor to cells. The lethal factor can then enter the cell and change how it makes certain proteins. Despite its name, the lethal factor doesn't always kill cells, but it can be modified to do so. In my research, I use anthrax molecules that have been altered so that their protective antigen can only deliver the lethal factor to cells that contain a specific helper molecule. If that helper molecule is only found in tumor cells, and the lethal factor has something added to it that kills cells, then my modified anthrax will specifically destroy cancer cells while leaving healthy ones alone. However, before we can unleash these modified anthrax toxins in people with cancer, we need to make sure that they only affect the cells we want them to. That's why I'm currently testing these anthrax molecules in a type of genetically modified mouse we call tomato mice. The cells of these mice glow red under a microscope because they have a gene that makes a red fluorescent protein. When my tweaked version of anthrax delivers its lethal factor to their cells, instead of killing them, the lethal factor causes the mouse's cells to make a green fluorescent protein instead of the red one, so they change color. In this way, these experiments can tell us which cells the anthrax affects and which it ignores. Using this approach, my colleagues and I hope to develop anthrax toxins that specifically destroy colon, lung, breast, and skin cancer cells. One day, our research could help lead to new treatments for all of those life-threatening illnesses.